Plenty of European opposition has looked to publicly downplay Mohamed Salah's contributions to Liverpool this. So far, none have survived. Yet that is the strategy of Real Madrid as the Spanish side looks forward to a Champions League final against Salah and the Reds in late May. Most recently, Madrid defender Sergio Ramos is the one to claim Salah is not the only focus for their preparation heading into the big game. "We have seen what Salah can do this, but he will just be one of 11 players we face against Liverpool," Ramos said. "Throughout my career, I have faced the best forward players in the world, many of them who are considered among the greatest ever. For me, there is never a fear," Ramos added. "A respect, yes, but never a fear." Salah has scored 43 goals for Liverpool this after coming over in the summer from AS Roma. He has 4 goals in his last 4 Champions League matches, and had a 3-match goal-scoring streak snapped in the semi-final away leg at Roma. The 25-year-old has also scored 7 goals in his last 5 Premier League appearances. Ramos also added a little jab, reminding everyone that Liverpool began their Champions League campaign in the qualifying stage. "We are ready to defend our title for a second time. We won't let it go easily. With all respect, maybe at the start of the campaign Liverpool were not the team people thought would be in the final. But they are here because they deserve to be here. We know as a team how to play finals, and we will be ready." Follow at the underscore bonfire. Arsenal's falling out of the UEFA Europa League was the final blow to Arsene Wenger's chances of winning a title in 2017-18 as the Frenchman's farewell tour with the Premier League giants continue. However, the focus of Thursday's 1-0 defeat 2-1 on aggregate to Atletico Madrid wasn't on Wenger, but instead his players, who were questioned for their lack of desire. One in particular was called out by Arsenal legend Martin Keown, who targeted Mesut Ozil and his lack of production not just in Madrid but on a number of occasions throughout the "Show some drive," Keown said. "Show some energy. He's on the edge of it. It's almost like his hands in the air, look at this group. They aren't as good as me. And somebody needed to grab him a long time ago, to give him a shake and say, we're trying to get the ball to you. We are working for you, but you're not working for us. I bet he doesn't play again this. He'll have some emotional breakdown and won't be able to play at the weekend. I don't know how many illnesses he's had this, but the fella is not kidding me. That is not a proper performance." Meanwhile, Keown suggested that the club's next manager, whoever it may be, needs to only play Ozil based on merit and not the price tag in which Arsene Wenger invested in the Germany international. "It's a big problem for the new manager because Wenger's invested an awful lot of money in this player and I'm not seeing a performance to go with it," Keown said. "He wasn't fit to wear the shirt for me tonight, and I've seen this a lot this and it needs to be said because he needs to be dug out because we expect more from him. He's a World Cup winner. These are crocodile tears that I'm seeing from the player. He's not conning me." Follow at Madrid Football. A long-standing dominance from Celtic in Scotland's top flight has created a clear divide at the top of the country's top flight, but their bitter rivals made a major move at the head coaching position that could help close the gap. Rangers announced on Friday the appointment of Steven Gerrard on a 4-year contract, as the former Liverpool midfielder succeeds Graham Murtagh as manager. "I am honoured to become the next manager of Rangers. I have enormous respect for this football club, and its history and tradition," Gerrard said following his appointment. "I can't wait to start this new journey at Rangers as we look to build on the many successes that this club has achieved." Gerrard, who completed his professional career in 2016 in MLS with the LA Galaxy, previously spent his time coaching Liverpool's under-18 squad in 2017-18 as his first official managerial position. The 37-year-old finished his place career with 186 goals in all competitions for Liverpool, which ranks 5th all-time in club history. Follow at Madrid Football. The Major League Soccer primary transfer window came and went with a bang, but a late move that didn't come to fruition has many wondering what could have been. It's not a name like Zlatan Ibrahimovic, but a sizable bid for Argentine forward Sergio Araujo was being reported by MLSsoccer.com on Thursday, as well as other outlets. More: Rashford, Marshall ready to prove themselves with Lukaku out. The Las Palmas goalscorer, currently on loan at AEK Athens in Greece, is believed to have commanded a $4 million bid from an unknown MLS side, per the report. However, the Spanish side rejected the offer. It was originally suggested that the LA Galaxy were the team that placed a bid for the player. However, with the Western Conference side having 3 designated players on the books, it would be very difficult to find a way to acquire such a player. Arroyo came up through the Boca Juniors Academy before signing professionally with the Argentine Giants in 2009. Since that time, the 26-year-old has spent time in Spain with Barcelona B and Las Palmas, as well as in Argentina with Tigre. This, Arroyo has scored 13 goals and added 5 assists for AEK, who has qualified for the UEFA Champions League ahead of the 2018-19. Follow at Madrid Football Paris at Paris Saint-Germain midfielder Marco Verratti will miss the rest of the after having an operation on his adductor tendons. PSG says the recent operation went perfectly well and the date was chosen in order for him to be ready for the start of next. More, Atletico tops Arsenal to reach Europa League final. Italy did not qualify for the World Cup in Russia, giving Verratti time to rest. The central midfielder has played 22 league games this, and last played for PSG on March 31 in the French League Cup final win over Monaco. PSG has 3 league games remaining, and the French Cup final against third division side Les Herbiers on Tuesday.